I've got a confession. I've never used a CO2 laser before. But AtomStack is going to change all that. Before we move on with this laser, let me tell you a little bit about it. The laser head has 0.01 millimeter carving precision, and it gets up to speeds of 600 millimeters a second. It does batch processing through a built-in 5-megapixel camera. The AtomStack works with Lightburn, plus they have an official software through AtomStack. The working area is at 500 by 300 millimeters, and that can be expanded to 800 to 500 millimeters with the conveyor belt. So this comes with the red light laser. This makes it a lot easier to adjust the laser because you can actually see it. So the AtomStack comes with a feature that I've never seen before, and that's the auto fire extinguisher. When it detects fire, it'll squirt water out on it. The water comes from a container that you put in the back side of the machine and you connect the hose to. There's an accessory port, a computer port, and a USB drive port. Another safety feature is the smoke exhaust system. It has an emergency off switch. It also has a key lock system, which I find very helpful because I have grandchildren that always come down to my shop. They've made tightening the belt a lot easier with the screw right on the outside, and it has the arrows and everything to tell you how to tighten it and loosen it. You can find all the information on their website. Just go there. I'll put a link down below, and you can just see all the stats and everything for this machine. All right. One of the most important things you can do is protect your lungs. I'm a very big advocate of having an air purifier for your laser system. You never know what's inside those plywood or anything else. So this is the AtomStack desktop version of the air purifier. You can turn it on. You can adjust the fans up and down. It also has a timer set. I'll put that down in the description so you can see what the specs are for it. So I got a confession. As soon as I got this thing out of the box and got it all hooked up, I went ahead and did a test engrave. And this is what I did right there. I got that thing right there and it came out fairly good. So what I did is I adjusted the laser a little bit and now I'm ready to do some cutting. So it's Christmas. So the first couple of projects I want to do are going to be Christmas related. I'm working on doing some ornaments for my grandchildren. The first one I want to do is an acrylic one, so let's go ahead and get that done. All right, it's done. I'm not sure how well this happened, but let's go ahead and look here. What? There it is, right there. My next one, I'm going to engrave inside there, but I think that's kind of neat. You can write stuff on there, and I can actually put names on there. I'm excited about this, but it cut extremely well. Well, that snowflake came out really good. I think I'm going to do some other stuff, design another snowflake ornament, and then we'll move on. But before I do that, I had a lot of noxious fumes come out because I was cutting acrylic. What we're going to do is hook up that air purifier and make sure that it doesn't smell that way and I'm not getting a lot of those noxious gases in my lungs. All right, so I'm cutting out this snowflake and I'm also engraving on it, so it's gonna make a lot of noxious fumes here. I've got this air purifier hooked up. I'm not really smelling anything, so it's doing a good job with the three layers that it has. It's important that you have some sort of air purification with your lasers because, you know, you never know what's inside these pieces of plywood or the acrylic and all that. You want to take care of your lungs. All right, this is almost done, so let's go check it out. All right, so I've got that done, but it's kind of waned off on the engraving on the top and on the sides. What does that mean? It means the laser needs to be adjusted a little bit. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and do an ornament out of 5-millimeter plywood. Haven't tested any of the plywood yet, so I'm hoping that their settings are good. So what we're going to do is we're going to test it out on one, and hopefully it'll be good. And if it is, we don't have to do another one, but we might have to do another one.
Broken. But let's see how it looks. That's pretty thin. I should have been a little bit more careful.
All right, so here it is. It is kind of it. I don't know. They had the file had like little holes in it and little things, and it made it a little bit too fragile. So I'm going to take those out. Also had the holes up here that you put string into. I'm going to take those out, and I'm going to set from 100 down to 80 on these settings for cutting it out and see if that works. I'll be right back after we cut one more.
Better.
All right, there it is, and it came out really nice. Hopefully it'll focus in on it. I decided not to make this any darker. I kind of like the way it is. If you want, you can make it more 3D by setting it deeper, and it'll burn in there deeper, and it'll look like more of a 3D effect on that. All right, that actually went pretty well. So what we're going to do is do one of these little balls here. And I've got the settings. I'm going to go really low to start off with and then slowly step up if I need to. So let's go ahead and get that one done. And all I got to do is take out the honeycomb for this one because it sets low enough. Barely, but it sets low enough. And then after that, we'll work on some other stuff. So there it is. It's complete. It looks fairly good, although I think I need to boost my settings up just a little bit. The goal of this is not only to get the blue on the outside, but the silver on the back side of this. And then what I'll do is I'll put some acrylic paint in the back and it'll pop it.
The claim to this machine is that it can cut 18 millimeter plywood. I don't have any 18 millimeter plywood. What I have is a 12.27 millimeter plywood, which is 12 millimeter plywood. So let's go ahead and see if that cuts.
All right, the cutting parameters for this is supposed to be 280, so that's what we're going to do. And with no further ado, let me cut this and I'll be right back to you. Wow, that did cut through really nice.
All right, as you saw, it cut fairly well. Let's see if we can get this. There we go. See that cut right there? That is a clean cut. Well, hold on. Let's zoom back out on this thing. It cut extremely well on this. I'm going to see if I can find some 18 millimeter plywood somewhere in my shop. I know I've got a piece somewhere. And if I do, what we'll do is we'll go ahead and try to cut it and see how well it cuts through with the settings that they give us. This is the AtomStack H3 riser base. What it does is it lifts up the laser system approximately 4 inches off of the table base. And once you take out the honeycomb and also the capture plate that's up underneath it, it will let you do larger projects in there. So it lets it sit on there by having placement holes in the top of the riser base where the feet of the laser go in there. There's 3 on each side and it fits in perfectly.
All right, it's time for me to give you the good, bad, and ugly of this machine. I'm going to give you 5 pros and 5 cons, and I'll let you know my recommendation once that's done. But first, we're going to talk about the cons. Now, taking this thing out of the box, it was pretty much complete and ready to go. But there's an issue. And that issue is my first con. It took a long time for me to get it focused in and adjusted correctly. I had to look at their videos online 300 or 400 times to make sure I was doing it right. I did end up getting it focused in. It took me about 1.5 to 2 hours. My next con was the camera. With the lid up, you have to adjust the camera, but the camera wouldn't adjust for me because it kept saying it didn't see the dots. Now, I'm going to caveat that number 2 one with the camera issue and say that I'm an idiot
And to tell you the truth, I could be doing it wrong because I've never worked with a CO2 laser before. Number three are belts. All these laser companies are using belts in all their machines. I'm not sure why they don't use a screw with a ball screw to propel it. It's a lot better, more accurate. I understand why they don't use lead screws, but now why not ball screws in these machines? I just talked about the ball screws and using those instead of belts. Well, if they use a belt and the belt breaks, all the encased machines have the same issue. You have to take apart half of the machine to be able to change out the belt. And if you have never done that before, you might be in a little bit of trouble. Number five is pretty petty for me, but it's the weight of this thing. It is so heavy, it takes two people to lift it onto the table or lift it off of the table. That means that I'm going to have to put it off to the side on a table because this is not the table it's going to stay on, and I'll have to bring somebody over to get it. So there you go. That's all the cons I have for this thing. It operated great. Now, let me tell you about the pros. So the AtomStack Hurricane cuts a lot of material. And that's my number one pro about this thing. It cuts a lot of material, but best of all, it cuts that clear acrylic. So my next pro, number two, is the way that you can adjust the belts without going into the machine. They have those screws right on the outside that help you loosen and tighten those belts. Number three for me is kind of a vanity thing. This thing is beautiful. Beautiful machine, and it's very sturdy and well made. Heck, look at the lid. It just thunks down and comes back up, and it is beefy. Number four, it integrated perfectly with my light burn. I had no issues getting it to find it and put it up as a machine. Number five, the riser base. It lets you do some larger things and some higher up things like my bowls to be able to just drop them in there and be able to use the laser to engrave my logo on them really helps. All right, so there you have it, my pros and my cons. So let me give you my unfettered opinion on this machine. Is this a good machine? Yes. Does it have its flaws? Yes. But comparing it to the other ones in the market that are $5,000-$6,000, I think this one's going to beat them out. At $2,700, you just can't go wrong with having a CO2 laser in your shop. I would rate this at about a 7 out of 10. I think they need to do a little bit more work on their app that connects to the laser. And I also think they need to work on making it a little bit easier to focus the laser and get the whole system set up. But overall, I think it's a fantastic machine. Now, would I recommend this for a beginner? No, I would not recommend this laser for a beginner. But you that have been working with diode lasers and maybe used CO2 lasers in the past, yeah, I think it's a great addition to your shop. I think AtomStack has come out swinging with this release. Matter of fact, I believe that it sold out as soon as it came on the market. But fortunately, they now have them back in stock. And in fact, they're doing a promotion right now. And I'll put the link to that promotion down below. All right, that's it. I think this is a pretty good laser. And my time with you has come to an end. I appreciate it. If you've had any experience with an AtomStack Hurricane or another CO2 laser, head on down to the comments. Leave it there. Let's help everybody make decisions. And until next video, stay cool.